Okay, it's been about 3 weeks since I've been able to work on this truck. I had a fuel pressure issue with the Isuzu Holden Rodeo, or Holden Rodeo, and that had to be diagnosed, the part had to come, and the fuel pump had to be replaced. This is my work vehicle for 2 weeks. It's got a 454 in it, and now how much did it cost? It cost about $140 a week. Work is about 87 kilometres away, and I worked 5 days, so 5 times 87 kilometres, and I had to spend about $140 Australian dollars. So anyway, I'll continue on with the door. The door was a completely unexpected thing. I wrote down a lot of notes of the work I had to do, and then what happened was the door wouldn't go up and down, and there was a clunking noise, and as you see in the previous videos, the whole electric door window regulator, it fell off and fell on the ground of the floor of the door here. And after looking into it and seeing what my options were, I chose to go for a manual window regulator that's in, but the other side's still electric, and the electric assembly sits here, and as you can see, it's fairly close to the crank handle, so it sits over it by about 20 millimeter. So what I might have to do is bring it right back as far as I can, and it'll probably clear it. I've got some new screws for the bottom of the cover here, and I just might be able to film it there. Oh no, I can't see it. It's just those metal pieces across there, and I drilled holes in them so the screws could go through the hole and hold the cover. I've got all these notes of the work I've got to do. Some of the work's been done, but not much. Thermostat, I need a cooler running thermostat because the 454s are known for running warm. The speedo's done. Speedo cable's been installed. I had to get a couple of sockets to remove some screws. For instance, the heater fan. The armrest has been patched up. I may still get a new armrest. I've got to find the paint. It's Sea Mist Green. This is a 1977 C20 made in California. The colour is Sea Mist Green. I've got these codes CC20, 90 and 3, or 43L, but that hasn't shown up anything. I'll repack the front bearings. I've got to get some sort of a dash protector. I've got to change out the brake fluid. I'm sort of resetting the car with all the fluids, transmission, brakes, etc. Power steering. Okay, I've got to chase up an 8-hole or 8-stud spare wheel, so I've got to get a spare wheel set up. It didn't have a jack or anything, but I've got the jack for it. Rear view mirror, I'm waiting for that to come. That's just a suction cup rear view mirror, because as we see here, it's actually never had a rear view mirror. That's the original glass. It's got the original 1970s glass warmer. Might be able to see the thread going through just there at the top of my finger. Anyway, I'm waiting for one of them to come, and we'll just go there. I've got to remove the airbags from the rear. What's happening there is there's airbags installed and there's leaf springs, and the leaf springs can't move because there's an airbag on top of the leaf springs. so I don't get any suspension. Yeah, spare wheel. I'll change out the fuel filter. The heater fan has to be fixed so that it works. I have to install a fuel pressure gauge and probably a rev counter. Purely just a rev counter just to see that there's the distributor's working, and the fuel pressure gauge to see if there's no deteriorating of the fuel pressure. Spare keys. Got to get spare keys. I've got to finish off the door. That's driver's side door there. Clean red lead connection. Oh, there's a few connections I want to clean. Electrical connections for the motor. Rust. I've got to do the rust. There's not much, just a couple of small holes and a bit of rust. Windows. Yeah, so that sort of coincides with the door window work. Grease the ball joints. Believe it or not, this truck's actually got greasable ball joints still, the way they used to have them. So that's a real bonus. Some rough rust behind the front bumper. All right, and that's pretty much it. This is all the bits and pieces I have to get, or I've already got. It's a bit of information about the paint colour. Sea mist green. So some of the parts there. I've got a washer bottle for the front windscreen. Dextron oil for the gearbox. Got some seat covers. I picked them up from work. They were free. Got a drainable automatic 2x400 with a drain bolt pan. Just bits and pieces. A filter for the automatic transmission. And just various other bits and pieces. Got handles for the door, but the handles have to be this part here, just the very front part on the outside, has to be made bigger so that it goes over this first bit here, but it won't go over this back bit here. Here you can see the sea mist green. They've got a sort of it's got a waviness to it, the way they've sprayed the door. You can see that green and blue type colour that when you look at the sea, you see that similar type of colour. Okay, so surprisingly, as you can see there, it wouldn't matter if this came back right to the edge here. There wouldn't be the clearance there anyway with the crank handle. Reason being is that the crank handle actually goes back about another, say, 5 mil, and so that's going to connect with that. Anyway, it can't go forward because the handle goes forward. So the only place for it is back here. That's it. Yeah, so it's still raining. That's the end of summer. It was the hottest summer on record. So, the hottest summer ever. I'm really glad it's over and there's some cooler weather. So I'm thinking, there is an area here, just down, just here. And if it was around here, there would be space between the door and the plastic cover. So in other words, if it went around there, then you can probably see there's enough room for it. Back here, it's a little bit far back, and it'd be more convenient the more forward it is, I think. Between the outside of the cover and the frame here, it's about 37. I beg your pardon, about 33 millimetre. And the gap between there and the back here is about 25, I think. Yeah, that's 25 millimeter. So we do have the space, we can redesign it. Okay, so that's it. I'm thinking at the moment that that's the best place to have the opposite side, the right hand window regulator button. All I did was just made a template from that side. I transferred it onto there. That's where the crank handle is going to be, and I've just got a square, squared it all up, and now I'll cut to the inside of that line. Okay, there was a very, very nice little bit of work. There it is, it's installed. Perfect size for the controller there. And I'll get that piece of plastic and I'll put it here. That's a good bit of work. Got some numbers here. The numbers are 36, 32, 31, blue. 36, 32, 35, green. 36, 32, 37, buckskin. 36, 32, 39, orange. And 36, 32, 41, red. And here we've got WK run, so I suppose it's a weekly run. 43, 51. And it's 1, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11. And the 11's upside down. Okay, so far so good. I've got this hole the right size. A piece of plastic from there went in here to fill in that hole, and there's my door handle spline, and so it's just a matter of putting the piece of plastic here to pack it out and installing the handle. Okay, so this is the backing plate for the crank handle. So the crank handle, the outside of it runs along here, along the face of the cover. This middle bit has to sit within the hole, and when you get these handles, you have to actually widen this point here and this point here. So I'll do that now. As you can see, it'll go on the spline, but it won't go any further. Once it meets the back bit, the bit behind the spline, which is that bit there, there's an indentation where the clip goes. There's a clip that sits in there, and that goes in there. But behind there, it won't go any further. So it's just there and there needs to be widened. Okay, we're ready to finish off the door. Everything works. The door opener, the lock, the window regulator, the control for the other side, the electric window on the other side. So let's put the cover on. Okay, so I'll bring through the controller for the window height on the other side. There's a clip there, and unfortunately when they assembled this they didn't put that that clip there on this side here. So what happens is when I install the frame, the control bit of it on the outside comes out, comes off the holder. So the best thing I can come up with is to put a bit of silicone, black strong silicone, around the inside here, just so that it stays together. Yeah, so that better illustrates it there. You can see that the holder's on. That's the inside of it there, and but the actual controller pops out. I don't think I'd be able to install this holder too many more times, because you can't keep on folding those bits at the edge back and forth, because they'll just snap off. Okay, I'll leave it there. I think it's wise to finish up for the day, instead of trying to maybe getting frustrated and trying to finish off the job. I was going to finish off the video with the installation of the door cover, but I think I'll retire for today. Okay, it's the next day, it's the 5th of the 3rd, 2017. Okay, you can get these holding clips out. See that holding clip there? So I'm able to get that out. And how I did that was just to bend back these two prongs on either side there. And they sit in under a ridge, so it won't come out. So that's the one installed on the right, and I got this one out of the left hand side there. And that in the middle of the picture there, that's a sort of a ridge, and these two bits sit in underneath that ridge. Okay, I've got to put this clip in there, like it is on the other side, but they just haven't—they never installed the one on this side. Okay, so that snapped in there pretty easy, surprisingly. So we'll see how it goes. Okay, I've got the orientation right, so should just clip in there, just like that. Well, it's on my mind. The secret to putting these on when they don't go on fully is that you just get a Stanley knife or something, you just cut a V at the very front here. So this notch here, you just shear it off a bit on an angle like that, just at the front, and you hammer the back lightly, and it will go on the shaft. It'll go past the spline and on the shaft. So in other words, that's a knife there, and you get it on an angle, not straight in, and you just take off the edge to create a V, and it'll go on. Okay, I've checked everything. As you saw in the previous videos, this has all been painted down there on the inside, so that if water gets in from the outside, it'll drain out and it won't rust out the bottom of the door. The rubber grommet or the packer is installed. The armrest is on. That's
the spline for the window regulator, and that's what the handle sits on the outside of the cover. That's the work I did in previous videos to install the frame of the window regulator, because as we saw, there's actually a hole there and a hole there, and there's two holes under here. Might be able to film it. And that was where the electric window regulator sat, and it just fell off the door because of the fatigue of the window regulator, and the weight and the movement just wore through the attachment points. So yeah, that's it, and that's the controller there on the inside. So I suppose I'll have to try and clean it up a bit, and I'll reinstall it. Okay, so I just brushed it off and used the air compressed can. So I turned the light on, so might be able to get you a better shot of that those fatigue worn out holes there, and the bottom ones. When I screw on the bottom of the door holder, that'll be going into these self-made brackets there. There's three down there, and I've got to put the clip in here. That's the factory attachment, and goes in that hole there, and it's smoothable, so when you put your screw in, it'll find the center itself. So just goes in that way. If you ever have to make up these brackets, the bracket hole falls sort of in this area here, so it's right at the end of this sliding bit there, so I'll just position it around about there, should be good. So you pull the door lever through first, and you position it over the top with the lock mechanism, and just push down. I've only got one clip here, so that clips in, and you center over your two holes here for your armrest, and that's it. Okay, the closest to the factory screws I could find were these 8G 25mm screws, Phillips head screws. That's the factory one on the left, and this one I got, so they're fairly close. Okay, that's the armrest I patched up. It's not particularly pretty, and I'll probably be replacing it, but for now it's good. So anyway, they're the two screws that they originally used, and it's just got two attachment points there. they screw straight in. I think when it rains, water gathers in this area here and here, and it causes rust. There was a fair amount of rust underneath here. You can see the repair of it in one of the previous videos. I'll tighten them up by hand. Okay, so to put a door handle on, just wind the window down a bit, and then you wind it all the way up, and this handle should be sitting on an angle like that, so it's sitting like that. So there's a clip on there, and that the area there of the clip sits into that that groove just behind the spline, and just in front of the shaft there. Okay, I'm finding that the handle's bottoming out on the shaft, so I'll have to remove the handle and cut a little bit off the shaft. So that is to say that the end of the spline here, this bit is just sort of packing, there's no spline, it's sort of a V shape, and what's happening is that's bottoming out on the end of the spline down there. So I'll just have to trim it little bit by little bit, and until it seats. I can refer you to a video if you'd like more information on installing a window regulator. It's 85C10 window regulator, and it's the channel is MJM Computers. MJM Computers 85C10 window regulator. Okay, I'll keep grinding it and trying to install it, and I'll keep going through that process until it clips on. Okay, I've now actually ground all of that nib off. The end's completely ground off, and I've needed all that spacing to get the handle to seat. I'm testing it. I've got a type of jam that I put on here, and it's actually going right down to the bottom of there. I can't really drill that out because I might damage the spline. And there's not all that much distance between here and the inside there, so I've just got to keep going and until it clips on. At this point I can actually prove that all of that metal had to come off the spline of the window regulator. If I see through there with a light, it's going to be very hard to film, but if I look through there, I can just see the edge of the spline and the lock-in area there. Try and probably won't show up, but it all had to be removed. Another thing, that clip actually turns around inside the gap you've got there. If the clip comes up against anything as you're rotating the crank handle, it'll pull the clip off. So you can see the clip won't really pass through that gap, so I'll have to open that up for it to work. Okay, so I've just removed that see-through cover. The only problem with grinding off all of the end of the spline is that the clip doesn't have anything to sort of ride on while it's getting onto the spline. So I'll just make sure the window is all the way up, and I think it's all the way up, so should just clip on. No. Sounds like it's clipping on. Okay, well, surprisingly, I tried the other handle. It came with two handles or winders, and it won't even go on. So we'll get the one that does go on, the same one. And I can hear it snap. It's got the other handles snap ring in, and that'll have to do. Okay, what the problem there was a number of things. Firstly, the hole, the spacer wasn't big enough. Secondly, the spline end and these crank handles didn't really meet up. I had to grind off a fair amount of metal off the end of the window regulator spline. And as well as that, the other handle didn't fit the spline pattern. You can see it's you may be able to see it's messed up inside. The amount of metal that I ground off the edge or the end was the right amount because it only just clips in. Okay, I know the previous video probably looked a little bit messy, but the upshot is that it all works good. I've got a good crank handle. It's tapered in. That's probably why the end of the spline shaft had to be ground off. You come up to grab the handle there, and you don't hit anything. So it's close to the inner edge there. And, all works good. Window goes up. When it goes down, you can put a fair amount of stress on it. It finishes at the right angle. This is a good, at a good height when you're sitting in the car. So that's how you sit in the car, and it's out of the way of my leg, and I can easily reach down to operate the controls down there, grab the handle. So she's all good. Just like to say that I purchased the window regulator and the handle from the same people, so I assume that they're matching. In the future, I may or may not fill in this gap on either side of the crank handle here, but it's not a bad piece of work.